When we meet a patient at a diabetic patient at a consultation, of course, diabetologists are very concerned with the chronic complications. And we look systematically for retinopathy, for nephropathy, for neuropathy, for cardiovascular disease. But generally speaking, we don't, diabetologists don't look systematically to periodontal status. And this is probably a kind of mistake because a relationship between diabetes, type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, and periodontal disease is now clearly validated in the scientific literature. We published very recently, we observed in a cohort of more than 100 patients with type 1 or type 2 diabetes that periodontal disease was much more frequent in controlled non-diabetic population. Bleeding from the gums was present in about 30% of patients with diabetes versus only 10% in the control group. And if you looked for the missing teeth, for important missing teeth, again, in patients with diabetes, 35% of the patients were concerned versus only 15% in the control subject. In the Pima Indians with diabetes, I think 65% had periodontal disease. In Pima Indians without diabetes, only 30% had periodontal disease. So an increase, risk multiplied by a factor more than 2. Conversely, it is also of interest to know that patients with a periodontal disease have an higher risk of pre-diabetes or of incident diabetes. The periodontologist, when he meets a patient with risk factors for diabetes, knows also, screens also for pre-diabetes or diabetes with the general practitioner or with the diabetologist. So the relationship between diabetes and periodontal disease is really a two-way, a bidirectional relationship, and it's important to know that for in daily clinical practice.